So the key points of discussion for this webinar is going to be introduction to the digital world, free project management tools, efficient ways of implementing this free project management tool, introduction to Google Forms and its key features for designing the survey form, and in the end we'll have a question and answer session. So now talking about our speakers, we have Mr. Ravi Shankar, the founder and director of the Majors Foundation. He has 21 years of working experience in the areas of quality, business performance improvement, operations management, project and risk management. He is also the founder of Majors Foundation that works towards enhancing the quality of education in government schools, people and process capabilities in social organizations such as NGOs, foundations, trusts, etc. Next, we have Mr. Kayat Johar, who is an electronics engineer and has been passionately involved in driving cultural change along with training, coaching, and facilitating project teams for business excellence frameworks, balanced scorecard implementation, Lean, Six Sigma, statistical analysis, and more in varied business sectors like stock exchange, banks, power plants, discrete manufacturing, pharmaceuticals, and FMCG. His experience is not limited to a particular sector or a country, but extends to across all sectors and various countries. So before we proceed ahead, I would just brief you with a few instructions. This session is going to be approximately around 1 hour 30 minutes, and post this session we can have a question and answer round if time permits. Please feel free to use the chat feature to post your questions. We'll answer them post the session. We'll also have event as run as smoothly as possible. There might be a few technical glitches. Please cooperate with us as your experience depends upon both your as well as the host or speaker's internet speed and connectivity during the session. This session is going to be a recorded session. What you can do if you can't hear us is that you can let us know on the chat wherever difficulty you are facing. You can check your internet connection, log out of the session and try logging in again. Do not message more than once on chat and WhatsApp with the same message, as it will hamper the experience for other participants. Do not mute and start speaking, rather message on the group and we will try fixing the problem if it is from our end. Keep yourself on mute throughout the activity so as to avoid background noise. We will let you know if there is need to unmute. If you have any query, please message on the group. ConnectFor will revert to you. Post the session, ConnectFor will be sharing the feedback form with you. Kindly fill all the form for us to improvise. You can fill the form post the event immediately or during the session. Now over to Mr. Kayat to begin the session and share his insights with us.
Thank you, Aparna, for that introduction. But yeah, can you mute yourself so you know I can see some interference coming from that side? Okay, thank you. So first of all, I would like to thank Aparna and ConnectFor for the opportunity. Secondly, guys, I'm here to introduce one of the project management tool, which is named as Trello. Just to give you insight that I'm not working for Trello. I'm just an independent consultant working for a different multinational company. And since I use the tool, I have found it very useful. And that's where, one of the members of ConnectFor had contacted me that if I can share some insights on how to use this tool. Okay. Now, before I start speaking about Trello and how it is to be done, I will be using a mix of Hindi and English because Hindi is our mother language. So, mujhe Hindi ko nahi chhodna side pe. I'll be using Hindi bhi aur English bhi. So, all of us can get onto the meeting. Sabko samajh mein aana chahiye. That's my objective. Because last 15 years of training experience, The only thing what I have learned is that communication barrier नहीं बनना चाहिए, communication ऐसा नहीं होना चाहिए जो किसी को नहीं समझ में आ रहा है, else it is not good. Okay. Now moving on to the topic. Let me okay, मैं अपना screen भी share कर रहा हूँ. So first of all, Trello क्यों use करना है? I mean, the first question is why you are using Trello. Okay. So I learned about Connect 4, and okay, there are many things what they are doing right now. Now when I came to their website, I looked at the projects. So बहुत सारे projects हैं जो Connect 4 team कर रही है. Like one is the webinars. One is the relief initiatives for COVID-19. दूसरा phone schooling भी है. So ये सारे initiatives या projects जिसे Connect 4 कहती है, इसको manage करना बहुत बड़ा problem होता है, क्योंकि अभी तो we are all at different place. हम सब हमारे खुद के घर पे है, and there is a problem because we cannot meet and ask every time. तो सबको phone करके पूछना हो गया क्या स्टेटस है, ये प्रॉब्लम हम लोग सब फेस करते हैं. एंड कभी कभी इट इज़ नॉट वेरी इजी कि हम लोग सबको फ़ोन करके पूछे बार बार. ओके सारे डॉक्यूमेंट्स, फिर बहुत सारे ईमेल्स एक्सचेंज होते हैं, बहुत सारे प्रॉब्लम्स होते हैं. नाउ मैंने उनका वेबिनार का पेज देखा, तो उनके पास बहुत सारे वेबिनार्स है. तो 1 जुलाई का उनका जो ऑलरेडी कम्प्लीट हो चुका है, 1 जुलाई को एक था, 8 जुलाई को, आज 29 जुलाई को एक है हमारा डिजिटल लिटरेसी, 22 को एक हुआ, एंड देन वैसे उनका फ्यूचर में भी होगा. नाउ ये सारे वेबिनार्स को उनको मैनेज कैसे करें, तो इसमें प्रॉब्लम्स क्या क्या आएगी इनको. जो आएगी प्रॉब्लम उसकी एक सिंपल लिस्ट है. अब सारे जो टास्क है, सारे जो वर्क जो डिवाइड होता है टीम मेंबर्स में, उसको कोलैबोरेट कैसे करें, उसको एक साथ में कहाँ रखें, कहाँ देखें. कोलैबोरेशन जिसे कहते हैं प्रोजेक्ट मैनेजमेंट का इम्पॉर्टेंट पार्ट, तो एक जगह पे सब कुछ कहाँ रखे, कैसे देखे. दूसरा होता है डिसीजन मेकिंग, कभी कोई क्वेश्चन है, कोई इंफॉर्मेशन शेयर करना है, तो या फिर आइडियाज जनरेट करना है, तो वो सारी चीज़ें कैसे करें. कम्युनिकेशन जो इंटरनल और एक्सटर्नल लोगों के साथ होता है वो कैसे करें. फिर कौन सा काम हो गया या नहीं हुआ, टास्क जिसे कहते हैं प्रोजेक्ट मैनेजमेंट में, टास्क कंप्लीट हुआ या नहीं हुआ. सो इम्पॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन है. अब हर बार हर एक छोटे छोटे टास्क का बहुत बार क्या होता है कि ऐसे टास्क में हम भूल जाते हैं, अरे ये भी करना था, फिर हमें याद आता है ओके ये तो मैंने इसका टाइम मिस कर दिया. तो ऐसी बहुत सारी चीज़ें जनरली छोटे या बड़े प्रोजेक्ट्स में होती है. इवन एज सिंपल एज गाइज, हमारे घर पर जब कोई फैमिली गेट टुगेदर अरेंज करते हैं या कोई बर्थडे पार्टी अरेंज करते हैं, कभी होता है जैसे कि बर्थडे पार्टी है राइट, तो हम हो सकता है पेपर प्लेट्स लाना भूल गए, बहुत छोटी चीज़ है, लेकिन वो एंड टाइम पे फिर हमें रश होता है. तो ये सारी चीज़ें को हम एक साथ में कैसे करें और मेक श्योर करें कि ये सारे टास्क हो रहे हैं. फिर टाइम मैनेजमेंट, क्योंकि हम और भी काम करते हैं, तो कौन सा काम पहले करना है, कौन सा काम दूसरा करना है, शेड्यूलिंग पार्ट, और वो काम वो टाइम पे हुआ है या नहीं हुआ, जिसे टाइम मैनेजमेंट कहते हैं. सो ये एक ऑब्जेक्टिव होता है प्रोजेक्ट मैनेजमेंट का. और लास्ट होता है किसी को काम देना, क्योंकि एक बहुत बड़ी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन है, बहुत सारे वॉलंटियर्स है, बहुत सारे दूसरे एनजीओ से भी कनेक्टेड है जैसे अपर्णा ने कहा. सो जब इतने सारे एनजीओ और इतने सारे वॉलंटियर्स होते हैं, तो एक दूसरे के साथ कनेक्ट करना, किसी को काम असाइन करना, किसी को काम देना ओके विदाउट मीटिंग देम, तो ये एक साथ पे एक प्लेटफॉर्म पे
And guide, if you can be by language, English can be both, please.
Okay, okay. Yeah, I think somebody muted me, so I didn't I was not able to talk. Okay. And my Windows sharing also stopped. So, okay. Aparna, can you give me a quick feedback where?
Sure, guys, you are on mute again.
No, I think there is somebody who is muting me again and again. Are you able to see my screen?
Yeah, it's showing that. Yeah, we can see your screen actually.
Okay, now I'm on this.
Yes, objectives of project management too.
Okay. Yeah, I think somebody is muting me, so it's not me, I'm muting myself. Somebody else. Maybe my mistake, it got muted. Fine. So. सो ये सारे प्रॉब्लम्स हैं हमारे प्रोजेक्ट मैनेजमेंट के, जिसे हम कहते हैं एक जगह अगर ये सब चीज़ें हम कहीं पर मैनेज कर सकते हैं, ओके, सब चीज़ों का अगर हमें कोई रिमाइंडर मिल जाता है एक प्लेटफॉर्म पे, एक जगह पे, एक विंडो पे, अगर हम ये सब चीज़ें देख सकते हैं तो कितना ईजी होता, एक क्वेश्चन आता है. तो ऐसे क्वेश्चन का आंसर होता है नॉर्मली कोई प्रोजेक्ट मैनेजमेंट का टूल, और उसमें से एक टूल है ट्रेलो, ओके, जो कि फ्रीली अवेलेबल है, कोई भी साइन अप कर सकता है. नाउ मैं वापस से कनेक्ट फोर के वेबिनार्स के लिए जाऊंगा, तो मे बी उनका जुलाई से पहले उन्होंने जब प्लान बनाया होगा, फिर उसके बाद ये उनके सारे वेबिनार्स है. अब ये सारे वेबिनार वो ये बोर्ड पे डाल सकते हैं, जिसे हम ट्रेलो का बोर्ड कहते हैं. सो ट्रेलो बोर्ड ऐसा दिखता है गाइस. नाउ पहला पार्ट होता है उसका साइन अप करना, ओके. साइन अप करने के लिए आप डायरेक्टली ट्रेलो पे जाके साइन अप कर सकते हैं, जो कि मैं आपको बताऊंगा. अदरवाइज अच्छा ये रहता है नॉर्मली के अगर आप किसी के इनवाइट से ज्वाइन होते हो, तो इससे जो इनवाइट करने वाला है उसे ज़्यादा चीज़ों का एक्सेस मिलने का, उसमें पॉइंट्स रहते हैं, जो एक्सेस वो लोग जितने लोगों को ज़्यादा देंगे उतना उनको फ्री सब्सक्रिप्शन बढ़ता जाएगा. तो ये मैं आपको बताने वाला हूँ. नाउ बट आई हैव जस्ट स्टॉप शेयरिंग माय स्क्रीन एंड आई एम शेयरिंग अगेन. सो ये मेरा अभी क्रोम वाला टैब है, अब साइन अप करना है इस पे. सो trello.com ये उसका साइट है.
गाइस सॉरी टू डिस्टर्ब यू, कैन यू मेक इट अ मिक्स ऑफ इंग्लिश हिंदी बोथ, बिकॉज़ सर्टेन पीपल आर नॉट अंडरस्टैंडिंग.
या श्योर, ओके. सो व्हेन यू वांट टू साइन अप, फॉर साइन अप यू हैव मल्टीपल ऑप्शंस. So for sign up, either you can use your Google account, which you may have already, or if you are using a Office 365, you can use a 365 account. It also gives you an option to create a new account. So, जैसे as soon as you receive invite, जैसे ही आपको invite आता है, let's say मैं अपना ईमेल आईडी डाल के उस पर साइन अप कर सकता हूँ. आई कैन साइन अप विथ माय ईमेल आईडी. सो दीज ऑप्शंस आर देयर एंड इट इज एज सिंपल एज साइनिंग अप फॉर एनी अदर अकाउंट आल्सो. वंस यू हैव साइंड अप फॉर दिस, यू विल बी रीडायरेक्टेड टू द ट्रेलो बोर्ड. ओके, सो ट्रेलो बोर्ड लुक्स लाइक दिस. So this is generally the Trello board, okay, and it has a lot of templates. Yahan bahut sare templates bhi hai use karne ke liye. All these names which you see are the different boards which I am using. Okay, one of the board I have created is for today's session, which is Connect for Webinars. Now before moving into everything, let me just set the agenda for what I'm going to cover. So in this I'm going to cover about sign up, which I have already covered. I will cover how to create a new board, how to add the members, team or individual, how to add the task and list. So kya kya kaam karna hai, kab karna hai, that task list. और क्या क्या डिटेल्स ऐड कर सकते हैं, जैसे कि चेक लिस्ट होता है, देयर इज अ चेक लिस्ट, डेट्स होती है, ड्यू डेट्स, सो देयर आर मेनी ड्यू डेट्स, एनी अटैचमेंट्स, डॉक्यूमेंट्स व्हिच यू वांट टू ऐड, हाउ डू यू असाइन टास्क टू मेंबर्स, हाउ कैन आई यूज एंड कॉपी डिफरेंट कार्ड्स, रीयूज द कार्ड्स अगेन, व्हाट अदर फंक्शंस दिस बोर्ड हैज, देयर इज समथिंग कॉल्ड एज पावर अप्स, where I can link my task to my calendar, to my Google calendar. So, you know, it's easy to synchronize between Google in my phone and everywhere. And then we'll be open to any question and answer, I think after the end of another session as well.
Okay.
So creating a new board. When you are at your home page, okay, you can always create a new board from here. So there is an option to create a new board. And when I click on this create new board, it will ask me for a title. Now, since I have already done for Connect for webinars, okay, and let's say Connect for is creating another board for their COVID-19 relief initiatives. So that is my board name. So every project is generally the board name, and then they can say create board. So board will be created for them. You can use different backgrounds, okay, if you want. You can use it for your organizational picture or team picture, and generally I prefer a solid color just for the simplicity purpose of text is visible. I can see the text. मुझे text easily read हो जाता है. So I am using always the colors. Now, of course, this is a new one. So when you create a board, the first thing that you would want to do is you want to get team on this. Okay, you want to invite people on your board. Now, as you can see here, you can make a team directly to join, or you can invite it by using a link. So the first option that it gives you is invite. So when you click on invite, there is an option of creating a link. So link is there. Now if I use this link and share it via email to anybody, so I can write an email. So this link will be sent to them. They click on this, they will be redirected to join the board. So they will be able to access the board. This is one way of doing it. Second way of doing it is I can create a team over here. Okay. So when I say team, so there are different teams. So let's say I have created, or I want to create a new team. But for creating a team, guys, the people have to join. They should have already be on the Trello platform. So that's why it is first you send them the link and then create a team from them. Okay. So when people join, let's say this is my this is the name of my team, Nama Lean Yellow Belt, and there are different members. Okay, so there are different members whom I can add or I can remove, or I can find by name also. Okay, so there are different ways of creating a team and bringing them on board. There is this one team which I have already created. So if you see, there are 15 team members in this one. Okay. Now I'm going back to my Connect for webinar part. So I can invite through this, or I can make it to my team. So this is about creating the team board. Second is, now there are two things. One is what we call as the task list. Second is the task. So task list is generally what I have used here from the website of Connect4 is they have different webinars. So one webinar is my one task list, because for that webinar I will have to do multiple things. Now digital literacy is one of them. Now here, so what I do is, if I want, if the Connect4 plans another webinar, okay, and that is, let's say, on MS Office usage. I'm just using some simple example. So I will say add list. Now that is being added. For this, for completing this webinar, there are multiple things which I will have to do. I will have to invite multiple volunteers. So the planning part comes here, and I will create a list. And so a similar brief list what I have created is, so what are the topics which will be covered? I don't know. So that needs to be done for my webinar. I'll go into the details of each of this card. Then who are the people who will present this webinar? From where can I get the experts? Who are the experts who can speak? So this is the speaker identification. Then sending the invite for the webinar. So for different NGOs and different people, I will have to send the invite. So this is one action, one task, ek kaam hai jo mujhe karna hai. Then there will be an agenda for the webinar. Okay. So which is for today. So let's say there is this agenda for webinar, and there was an introduction which was played earlier and done by Aparna. Then there was introduction of speakers, which is being done. Now I'm doing the Trello board presentation, post which we have one more. And then we will get into a question and answer session. So this is how I'm adding details about my task over here. Then there is a Trello board, then there is a presentation. So in summary, what we are doing here is we are trying to identify the task, identify kya kaam karna hai mujhe. Okay. Ab ye, this is the first element whenever you break up any project to your actions. So what we call in the project management language is the task. So यहाँ पे दे यूज द वर्ड कॉल्ड एज कार्ड्स. सो ट्रेलो बोर्ड जो है वो टास्क को कार्ड्स के नाम से जानता है. सो दीज आर ऑल कार्ड्स, एंड ये लिस्ट होती है, कार्ड लिस्ट. सो ये एक मेरा कार्ड है. नाउ टॉपिक्स फॉर ट्रेलो बोर्ड डिस्कशन, ये मेरा एक काम था. ओके, नाउ हियर आई हैव एडेड व्हाट एम आई गोइंग टू कवर. सो टास्क में क्या क्या चीजें आप ऐड कर सकते हो? सो यहाँ पे बहुत सारी चीज़ें ऐड हो सकती है गाइस. फर्स्ट उसका डिटेल, सिंस ऊपर खाली नाम है, उसके बारे में कोई भी डिस्क्रिप्शन आपको ऐड करना है, यू कैन ऐड इट ओवर हियर. एनी डिटेल्स अबाउट दिस टास्क, व्हाट इट इज रिलेटेड टू, व्हाई, ऑल दैट इंफॉर्मेशन यू कैन ऐड. सो इट्स अ डिस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ द टास्क विच यू आर एडिंग. Another element, okay, so I will look at it from the right hand side. So it gives you multiple options what you can do from this card. Now this task is not supposed to be done by me, okay, there is somebody else who needs to do it. So is there a member who I can assign it to? So let's say I will assign it to Samina. Okay, now when I do this, you can see the tick mark, and you can also see that the initial of SB has been added. That means Samina will receive a notification that this task has been assigned to you. And what is the detail? You can capture everything over here. So first thing, ye kaam kisko karna hai? Who needs to do this? That you can assign it over here. But first you will have to invite the member to the board, and then you can assign it to the task. Second is any checklist. So task ke andar multiple options ho sakte hai, multiple cheeze jo karni ho sakti hai. So ek checklist jo hoti hai, jaise ke mujhe kya kya karna hai, to I use this checklist. Okay, for me to remember, to mujhe aapko kya kya batana hai. So maine aapko sign up for Trello bata diya. Now creating a new board bhi maine aapko bata diya. मैंने आपको बता दिया हाउ आई हैव शोन यू हाउ टू इनवाइट मेंबर्स टू बोर्ड इधर टीम और इंडिविजुअल बोथ साइड्स ओके देन आई हैव एक्सप्लेन टास्क एंड टास्क लिस्ट सो मेरा एक टास्क है प्रेजेंटेशन आई वांट टू कवर द टॉपिक्स फॉर ट्रेलो बोर्ड उसके अंदर विद इन दैट देर आर मेनी सब टास्क और information which as and when I complete I want to be in track of and not only me I want everyone else so they can visualize where what is the progress so far on this so creating task and task list and we are discussing on this adding the elements on card now one of that is checklist so you can add a as many checklists as you want as many items as you want in the checklist in this checklist so it could be as simple as if you are arranging a birthday party and you know that these are the items to be you know covered for that birthday party you can have the items listed over here or let's say you have a certain volunteers to be nominated so what details to be collected from the volunteers So I can have their CV and maybe additional details. So all that can be a part of my checklist here. Now, after that checklist comes, by when the task should be completed? Till when I should finish the task? So here is an option of my due date. Now this is what we call as due. Now topic of our today's discussion. So I have selected today. That's the date, time 4 p.m. And when you want to set the reminder, so like any other normal calendar, when you want that to be reminded, whatever you select, you will get a email notification of this. Okay, so you can say save. So you can see here today at 4 p.m. overdue. Now, whenever it is due, it will show as red. Let's say if I push the date for tomorrow, now this will turn yellow because it is due tomorrow. And if I push it to next week, it will not have any reminder. So it also works as a visual mechanism because anything which is red, it will be highlighted to you or it will come to your eye very easily. So I can see very easily, okay, 29 July, that's today, it's red. That means I need to be focused about this. And not only overdue, but when you complete this task, you can do a tick. So it will say complete. Unless it is complete, it will show you overdue. And you click on this checkbox, it will say complete. So this is how I get use my due date. And since I have many people working, you know, I may have a lot of attachments to add. So one of the example over here is that since we are talking about this Trello, now post this webinar, you may require some guidance, some assistance on this. So there is an attachment which I can add. So there is an option that any kind of a attachment, either it can be your computer, either it can be on your Google Drive, OneDrive, or any YouTube link or any other link. So let's say we want to get a feedback from you today and there is a Google form designed for it. So I can paste the link for that Google form. which will be very easy for anyone to access it. So I don't need to send emails. Basically, what can be reduced is the time and the efforts. So this attachment, now I can directly open it from here. Now, post this training session, post this webinar, you know, in case you need any help, all this with screenshots, it's available in your Trello board. And this PDF can be available to you. So it makes the job very easy. And like this, any kind of attachments which you want to add, irrespective of the file format, it can be as easy as a JPEG image also, or it can be documents. Only thing is that since it is a free version, it restricts the limitation of one file size to a 10 MB file, not more than 10 MB. I can have multiple files, but the single file cannot be more than 10 MB. So that's your attachment. And I may want to make it more visuals, more visually appealing, so I can add labels. Now these labels can be named as anything. So right now what I have given here is a label which is based on priority. Okay, so whether it's a low priority, high priority, I will say this is my high priority task. So as I select this, you can see there is a change that has happened here, and there is a change that has happened here. You can see the small high. So visually, it makes me understand, okay, what needs to be done first, what needs to be done second, how I should manage my work. Anybody else doing the changes, you will be able to see here. Okay. And I may want to add any other label also. So let's say I create one more label, which is of blue color, and I will say that is for Connect 4. Since I may have for multiple people, I will say Connect 4. So I have selected both of these. Now, if you see here, there are two labels. High, there is a priority, and what it is for. So depending on my usage, I can select labels. So that way, visually, it is making more understandable. Some simple things what you can do is, so there are certain, since there are many tasks over here like this, I want to be notified about, so I don't want to be notified about this, but I want to be notified about this task where we are talking about resource identification or the speaker identification. So I want to be notified whatever changes happen here. So what we do is, I will select myself as watch. Okay, you say a watch over here. Now when you say watch, any activity happening here will be notified to you. Okay. So since I have selected any activity which somebody else is doing, any comment which anybody post, that will be notified to you via email which you have signed up for. Also, you can notify people directly by writing in comments. Okay, so let's say at Samina, since she is already there on the board, I have found the speaker for Trello. Somebody wants to post this comment. So they post this comment. Okay. Samina will be notified about this, even though she has not subscribed to this. This is called subscription. Even though she has not subscribed, she will receive an email because I have tagged her. Okay, you know this social media thing, guys, that you can tag people. So this is as good as tagging. And she will receive this comment. So she knows, okay, this is done. So this is how you can keep on adding comments. Now, if Samina wants, she also can write any activity comment, which I will be able to see here. So that is one more thing what you can do with this task. Then there are certain which you may want to, you know, change task from one list to another, or you may want to copy that task to another list. So let's say this is done over here and I want to copy this task for another webinar which is upcoming. So I want to copy this task. So what I can do is either I can go inside, I can say copy. So when I say copy, now where to copy it to? So I will say I want to copy it to the other one or on the same board, connect for webinars. Now which list I want to make it for the last one, MS Office usage. And I will say create a card. So since I have copied that, now you can see there is one more card which is created for MS Office usage. Now this is very handy because doing a copy paste and moving option is always a part of our life, and so is in our project management. Even if I want to copy this entire thing, okay, outside of it there is a pen option. You click on this pen, you can copy. So whatever you want, you can copy from here to, let's say I want to bring it for livelihood options, a card create. So card has been created in the same way like here. So this copy card option is available. Okay, so let me go back to my list because that's my guidance. So we have talked about description, checklist, due date, attachment, labels and activity. So activity is this, whenever you want to write something and post something, instead of sharing too many emails, one comment will be easier to send to all of them. Then adding members to the task. So you can add members from here, which I have shown you. Move and copy cards, I have done. Okay, so this is all related to my cards, which is what we call as task. Jo hamara task hota hai, uske related. Now, there are certain options available, but this is generally for paid version, so I don't want to show these two here. Next is board function. So you may want to copy an entire board. You want to send it to somebody who is not using Trello. Okay, so there is a menu option over here. So when you right click on the on your right hand side top corner, when you click, you will find different menu items. Now when you click on more, you will find this option of copy board. So if I want to copy this entire board, I can copy this. So it will create a copy of it, same like it created a copy of the task or the card. It will create a copy of the entire board as it is. You want to print and export this. Okay, so you can export it or you can print it. Now simple ways, you can print it to a PDF format and send it to anybody. So this entire task, all this card list will be sent, but they will not be able to see the attachments or read the attachment since they can only see the task list. So you can copy or print and export, or if you are not using it, you can close the board. Okay, you want to share it with somebody, here is the link for the board. So these things what you can do with the board itself. You can change your background over here, guys. So depending on my, let's say I want to put my organizational picture over here, or the logo, or the any team background, anything you want, you can add over here. Next is, okay, I'm coming here again. The last one, there's a power up link to calendar. Okay. So since this is a free version, and as I said in the beginning, it works on invite. So when I have sent Samina the invite, okay, I will earn one free month of say, let me go to my home and I will say, they call it the gold. Okay, I have earned the gold, Trello gold. So Trello gold is like undiscovering or rediscovering all the features. So since you can see some names over here, these people have joined. So I can see my credit. So this is a credit which I have earned. Now, since there are more than 12 people who have joined, I think their maximum year what they can give is 12 months of free Trello. That is Trello Gold. So like any other, you know, software, free software, there is a free version and the paid version. So with paid version, you will be able to assign timeline for individual task in the checklist also. So in case you want to do so, you can do it. So my advice is, you know, that if you have an invite, you are already on the board, you invite to 12 people and let that chain pass on. So everybody can get a benefit of this Trello Gold. And in case you need to use it, you can use it. Even if you don't go for Trello Gold, it is absolutely fine, because right now you can see I have received, but all of them is as it is pending, because I don't feel the use of going for Trello Gold. So this is just for information. Okay, nothing much. But the last one and the most important function of the Trello board is linking with the calendar. Okay, linking with the calendar, guys. So yeah, sorry, one more thing I will explain here. Like you had watch for card, similarly you can watch all activities of this board. So if I click on watch, any changes made to any card anywhere, it will be notified to me via email. I generally do not prefer this, because otherwise it creates lot of emails, lot of notifications. But in case you want to monitor it from the as a whole, you can do it. Last function which we all of us need is, since we all are using smartphone, okay, and most of there's a statistic says that 80% of the phones are Android phones which uses a Gmail. Now there is an option when you click over here, they call it the power up. Okay, I can power up and I can add calendar. So which is the most important function which I see, like Google Chrome has extension, similarly Trello has this power ups. So there is something they call as calendar. Now what happens with this, let me show you first and then I will explain. When you say calendar, you click on add. Now you will find that this tab has been added to my board. Earlier it was not there. What will happen is, wherever I have timeline, okay, I'll put another time for this, just for, you know, understanding purpose. Wherever I have this, if I click on calendar, you will see that task over here, which is the most required function which I see. But not necessary every time you go to the Trello board, go to your calendar and see. I need simple notifications. So what you do is, you click on the settings, and when you click on settings, you have a link again. That's for your calendar. You click on this link. Okay. Initially, when you begin, it will be like this. So make sure you click on enable sync, and then you will get the link. Copy the link. Then what I would do is, I will come to my Gmail and calendar. Okay. So I will open my calendar here first. In my calendar, on the left hand side, you will find this option, plus. Okay, you click on this plus from URL. So the link which I had copied, now I will paste. make sure it is complete with this .ics extension, and I will say add calendar. So now connect for webinars, you can see this over here. And now when I go back to my calendar, you will find both these things added. So it is now linked to my mobile phone. So I will be receiving notifications on my phone itself, which will make sure that I don't miss out on any task. I don't miss out on any timeline. So this is a very important one. And if you want to close, you can close this. Again, come back to your original board. So that way, this is the last one. Link to calendar and limitation of free version. I told you two things, guys. One, you can only upload file of 10 MB. One file of 10 MB, more than 10 MB, it will not allow. Okay. And for this checklist, if you have a paid version, so let's say if I want to schedule this task and this to a resource, I cannot do it because it will say that you have to upgrade. I don't want to upgrade. I'm fine with the free version. So that's all I had for the discussion. I'll be open for the Q&A session post. I think there is one more topic. So any of you have any questions, guys, you can keep your questions ready. Okay. Aparna, over.
Thank you. Yeah, sure. Thank you, Mr. Kayal, for a detailed explanation on Trello. Now, over to Mr. Ravi, who will take us through the process of using Google Forms.
Okay. Thank you, Aparna, for the introduction. Hello, everybody. My name is Ravi. I hope I'm audible.
Yes, Ravi, you are audible.
Great. Thank you. Thank you. So that was a very good presentation from Kaid on Trello, which is a project management tool. One comment I would say from my side is project management is a very important concept in any organization you're working, any social organization, NGO, trust, or a corporate. Today, that is very much in demand in terms of a skill set, right? So I would strongly encourage each one of you to follow the project management concepts. Of course, Trello is one of the great tool, as you said. Some of you may be familiar with another tool, that's fine. But use it on a regular basis. These are some important things in your daily work. Okay, with that short introduction, I will start off. Before I start, a request to Aparna and Samina, just in case if my audio gets cut or my presentation goes off, please remind me because I may not realize myself. Okay.
So, sure enough.
Okay, great. Okay, so I hope my screen is visible. So we are here to now discuss about Google Form. So before I jump into Google Form, a little introduction. Firstly, as Aparna said at the beginning, there are so many types of forms. Google Form is most popular as of now. You have Microsoft Forms, Pro Form, and so on. Most of them are free. So why Google Form? Yes, as even Kait mentioned, Gmail, many of us, I'm sure, have Gmail as their ID, right? And that's one of the key prerequisites. So given that Google Form comes naturally with it as a free add-on with any Gmail ID you have, I'll show you that in a minute. Of course, you can also use Microsoft Form also. Maybe we can talk about that on another day. What's the difference? But they're largely very similar in nature. Okay. So before I go ahead, very basic introduction of what is a form in the first place, right? Forms are used to capture certain information from the target audience. See, any application form you look at, if you look at the conventional approach, you used to have a hard copy printout. We have been filling up the, let's say, a bank application form or a school application or a college application. Even when you joined in the jobs, you're filled in an HR application form. So filling up of forms, I think we all have done in different points of our lifetime, right? So that is there. But that has been very manual in nature till some time back. So if I look at a typical data collection process of a manual form, you start with creating a form. Each one of us would design our own form, like name, gender, address, age, you know, and so on, email ID, mobile number, etc. And you, whether it's a hard copy or Excel file or a Word, you then have to email that form as an attachment individually, right? If it's a hard copy, you have to scan it. If I create it in a Word document or an Excel, attach that. And if I have to send it to, let's say, 20 people, I want to get some information from 20 participants. If it is 100, 200, you know, the complications increases. So then you have to email them one by one. Though there are bulk email methods, I'm not talking about that. Then once you receive responses, again, in the form of attachments, each one of those respondent would save the attachment, fill it up, again, attach it back and reply back to you. So let's say even if you're talking of 50 responses, you're talking of 50 emails with 50 attachments. Then what do? You compile all the information from each of those attachments and you have to tabulate in one single table, right? Because you get 50 attachments, you have to copy paste into one single file, again, an Excel or a Word, again, it differs. And then finally, you would analyze it for any specific requirement you have. So this is a typical flow that all of us would have either done it or would have experienced as a user, right? Now, the question is, how about automating these steps, right? If these three steps are automated, the emailing of the form, collection of the responses, and then the compiling part. So that part, if you automate, there's a huge manual effort that can be saved. Of course, creating a form, it varies. We have to create our own forms. Analyzing is naturally, it's our brain power. We have to use it whichever way we want to analyze. But the majority of the manual work is in these three steps. And how about automating this, right? And that is where you think about Google Form. So, or any other form for that matter. Today we are talking about Google Form. So what is a Google Form, right? As I said, the first and foremost condition is you need to have a Gmail ID to create a Google Form. And as I said, I'm assuming many of you must be having Gmail ID. If you don't have, at least for the sake of using some free features of Google, you can just create one Gmail ID and keep it. You don't lose anything, right? I know there are quite a few people who still use Yahoo and Rediff and Hotmail. That's fine. But using a Gmail ID, you get many other benefits as well, not just Google Form. So from a creator point...
Raviji, can you read English and Hindi both?
Okay. Sure. No problem. I was talking about my Hindi skills. I'll try. So if I just take a step back, see, these are the various ways of creating manual forms, which many of us have done it. Hum sab log kabhi na kabhi koi na koi form create kiye honge, Word ya Excel hoga, or even hard copy, or we would have collected the responses, or usko compile karke analyze bhi kiya hoga. So the major work, majority of the manual work is in these three steps. Ye teen jo kaam hai na, email bhejna ek ek aadmi ko, agar maan lijiye 20-50 emails bhejna ho to kitna mehnat lagega, fir aapko reply bhi aayega, fir ek ek attachment ko khol ke you have to compile it, ek ek copy paste karna hai, and copy paste is an easy job but bahut galtiyan bhi ho sakte hain, right? So and then you analyze it. So this is where you are looking at Google Form. Wo jo teen key steps hai, which are very manual in nature, we are trying to automate that. Okay, so each one of us, as I said, need to have a Gmail ID to create a Google Form. But anybody can submit the form. मतलब कोई भी submit कर सकता है. अगर मेरा पास Gmail ID ना भी हो, I can reply to somebody else's form. Right? There is no limitation. Replying anybody can do, as in filling up the form, form fill करना है, submit करना है. So that can be done by anybody. लेकिन अगर आपको फॉर्म क्रिएट करना है, गूगल फॉर्म क्रिएट करना है, फिर आपको जीमेल आईडी होना जरूरी है. अदरवाइज यू डोंट हैव एक्सेस टू दैट.
फर्स्ट रवि सर, आई जस्ट हैव वन क्वेश्चन.
यस.
इफ आर डोमेन जीमेल आईडी और डोमेन आईडी, लाइक आई एम वर्किंग फॉर युवा परिवर्तन, सो माय ईमेल आईडी इज लाइक संध्या@ youaparivartan.org. But correct. This email ID is synced with the Gmail.
Correct.
So it will work?
Yes, yes, it will work.
Okay.
Yes. See, as you rightly said, that's a good question. काफी कंपनीज क्या करते हैं, दे टेक अप द जी स्वीट, इट्स कॉल्ड राइट जी एस यू आई टी जी स्वीट सब्सक्रिप्शन, जी स्वीट, यस जी स्वीट के साथ यू गेट मेनी एप्स, एक्सेस टू मेनी अदर एप्स, अगेन देयर आल्सो यू हैव पेमेंट ऑप्शंस एंड डिफरेंट एप्लीकेशंस यू हैव. सो अगर आपके पास जी स्वीट है, इवन दो यू आर यूजिंग योर कंपनी आई डी, यू स्टिल हैव एक्सेस टू दिस. यस दैट्स इट. ओके. So the first key point is it's an online form, as we already spoke, to capture the required information, and it will avoid sending mails. मतलब एक-एक mail भेजने का ज़रूरत नहीं रहेगा. I will be showing a live demo in another 2-3 minutes. So you don't have to save the attachment. अगर 20 लोग को भेजना है तो 20-20 mail भेजना है. Even if you put it in BCC, one mail marking to 20 people, that is fine. लेकिन आपको रिप्लाई तो आएगा ना, 50 मेल्स रिप्लाई आएगा. सो यू देन हैव टू सिट एंड कंपाइल. सो दैट एफर्ट विल बी रिड्यूस्ड, एंड इट्स एन इमीडिएट एक्सट्रैक्ट ऑफ रिपोर्ट. सो ऑल द रेस्पॉन्सेस दैट यू गेट थ्रू गूगल फॉर्म यू कैन इमीडिएटली डाउनलोड. वी विल बी डूइंग अ लाइव डेमो ऑफ अ फॉर्म. आई विल बी क्रिएटिंग अ फॉर्म राइट नाउ एंड आई विल बी सेंडिंग टू 3-4 पीपल फ्रॉम कनेक्ट फॉर हू वॉलंटियर्ड. वी विल सी अ लाइव डेमो हाउ इट वर्क्स. And there are certain rules. हर एक फील्ड का कुछ कुछ रेस्ट्रिक्शंस रख सकते हैं हम लोग. फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ यू से एज एज अ फील्ड, द मोमेंट यू पुट अ नंबर एज अ फील्ड, यू कैन पुट अ रेस्ट्रिक्शन दैट द एज शुड बी अबव 18 ईयर्स. मान लीजिए आप कुछ यू आर रनिंग वन ट्रेनिंग प्रोग्राम विच इज ओनली फॉर ग्रेटर देन 18 ईयर्स ऑफ एज पीपल. सो इफ somebody इज एंटरिंग एज एज 15, it will not allow them to fill the form. So that kind of restrictions you can put in. And then mandatory option also, right? I will show you in the live demo, it will be clear. Then there are ability to give options. Like, you know, you say, are you willing to attend Connect for training? Yes, no, these are the options. And what are the date options you are willing to attend? 29th July, 30th July, 1st August. राइट, ऐसे अलग अलग ऑप्शंस दे सकते हो आप. राइट, एंड मेक द फॉर्म इम्प्रेसिव विद फोटोज. आप फॉर्म के अंदर फोटोज भी लगा सकते हो, आपका कंपनी का लोगो होगा या कौन सा भी टॉपिक के ऊपर आप फॉर्म भेज रहे हो, देन यू कैन ऐड फोटोज रिलेटेड टू दैट टॉपिक. ओके, सो दैट इट मेक्स इट लुक गुड. यू कैन इवन अटैच वीडियोज ऑल्सो, लिंक्स टू वीडियोज टू मेक इट इवन मोर इंटरेस्टिंग. राइट, and there is also a quiz option. Okay, so the one is regular form, matlab aap form create kar rahe ho, you are sending it to people, they fill it up. You can create a quiz, let's say 10 questions with ABCD options, and you can input the answer key. First question right answer is option C, second question right answer is option B. That of course only you will be able to see, kisi aur ko nahi dikhega answers kya hai. But when you send these that quiz form link, and when they respond to that, you don't even have to correct. आपको correct करने की ज़रूरत नहीं. The Google form will immediately give you the results. Okay, Ravi has replied to this quiz of 10 questions. Out of 10, how many correct answers he got? Instantly you will know. And which are the questions he went wrong? So you can analyze the quiz results. You know, or even a test. It can be a test or a quiz, whichever it is. But it has to be a multiple choice only, not a description. Okay. So now we'll go to a live demo. So, जैसे मैंने आपको बताया, you need to have a Gmail ID. So this is the Gmail ID of my company name, Magis Foundation @gmail.com. So I just created to use the Gmail options, and in the Gmail screen at the top you see these 9 dots. Those are Google apps. Just click that. Okay, once you click that, you see these are the various you know, apps of Google that you have. All of these are free, of course with a limited access. They are free and some of them are very nice. Isme aap Google Drive pe jaiye. You see this drive, the triangle shaped drive. So you need to click this. Once you click the drive, it opens up a new page. Now, these are the different, already I have some forms and, you know, folders that I created. So this is a Google Drive, your Google Drive. Aapka jo bhi email ID hai, your email ID is Google Drive. And the best part is you get 15 GB free space, you know, that you get for free. If you want more, you can buy the storage. For normal documents, like anybody creating Word, PowerPoint, Excel, is type ka files ke liye 15 GB is a lot of memory. Okay, so please use this Google Drive to your advantage. It's very, very useful because in your computer, the file can crash and all of that, delete all of that. But if you save it here, it will be safe and you can share it with people also. So here in this Google Drive, you can see the new button here at the top. You click this new. Once you click the new, these are the various options you get. Okay, you can create a folder, the folders that you see here. I created a folders like that. So I'll not go through other options. You go to this more, and in more, the first one is Google Form. Right? Samajh gaye na sab log? So aap idhar new pe click kijiye, go to the more option, and in the more, you see Google Forms. Okay? Click this Google Form. Then it will open another window. Now this is a blank Google Form sheet that now you are creating. So we'll create one right now as I'm explaining to you, so we can see a live demo. So the name is says is untitled form. So you click here, you can give any name you want. Okay, I'm just giving connect for trial form, and you can give description. Abhi the description bhi de sakte ho, just to explain what this is. This form is to capture information about the training participants. You know, anything you want. Right? You can write long text also. So these are the two things. Now, ek cheez dhyan rakhiye, there is nothing called save to save in this Google Form. As you keep on doing or adding fields or typing, it will automatically get saved. You can see this comment, all changes saved in Drive. And this happens immediately. I mean, at best, you can just give a 5 seconds pause. You can be 100% sure, oh, save, okay, oh, right? There is nothing to do, save or control S, you don't have to do anything. And this is the name of the Google Form sheet. Okay, so this is also saying untitled form. Whatever name you have given here, the same name will come. Just click there once. You saw that? Jaise maine udhar click kiya, apne aap jo bhi idhar naam tha wo aa gaya. So that is the name of this Google form. Okay, just do that once. So that is how it will get saved with that name. Now let's create a form. Untitled question means what is the name of the field? I will say name of the participant. Okay, and here you click the drop down. These are the different types of answers you want to capture: short answer, paragraph, multiple choice. I'll explain 2-3 options. Short answer, name is a short answer, right? However long the name is, that length of the character is enough. And you see this button required. If it is gray, means it is not a mandatory field. Matlab, even if somebody leaves it blank, agar aap blank bhi chhod doge, you can submit the form. Form will accept it. But agar maan lijiye aapne isko aisa click kiya, this is purple color or purple, dark blue, whatever, right? This purple color, then it is required, mandatory. Matlab, if you don't fill this field, Google Form will not accept the response. Okay, or Google Form accept nahi karega wo response ko. If you mark it as required. So I am marking it as required. I want name, compulsory. Okay, once you do that, you say add a question. The moment you click plus, it goes to the next section, right? What will I say? Email ID. I can type email ID, mobile number, all of that. So I am just keeping one option. I'll say this is also required. Next, what will I say? Are you willing to attend the training? The moment I entered, are you willing to attend the training? Google form is intelligent. थोड़ा समझदार है वो. It is automatically suggesting to you yes, no, maybe, right? मैंने कुछ नहीं किया, अपने आप बोल रहा है. Because the, it is understanding the question, the you know, the language of this question. So if I just simply say add all, अपने आप yes, no, maybe आ गया. And I didn't have to type, right? Suppose if I want to do it myself, I'll show you how to do it. Individually, see, it would have been like this short answer. Are you willing to attend the training? You got the option yes, no, maybe. Up click kijiye, immediately it is done. But let I want to show you a different method so that you learn. I tick here and I see multiple choice. If I say multiple choice, now I say option. Now I'll type yes. There says add option. You just click the button, click the cursor at add option. Automatically it will get added. See, apne aap no le liya. Google form ko jyada hi samajhdar, right? So it's helping you a lot. So which is good. Yes and no. Only this much. This is also required. Now, here I can say based on the answer, you can go to a different section, right? Go to section based on answer. I select this option. The moment I select this option, it will tell if it is yes, I am saying I need to go to another section. Right now I didn't create. I will create a section. I'll show you. If it is no, that means they are not interested to attend the training. So the story ends there, right? Kuch to karna hi nahi hai. So I will say submit form. The moment if you click no, it will directly take them to submit form. Now I'll add a new section. You see this button? Is a do line dikh raha hai na? This is called add section. See any option, and this is common across most Microsoft applications. अगर आपको पता नहीं है वो चीज क्या है ना, जस्ट टेक योर माउस टू दैट पॉइंट. इट विल शो अ शॉर्ट डिस्क्रिप्शन. सी, इट सेज ऐड इमेज, इट सेज ऐड टाइटल एंड डिस्क्रिप्शन. यू नो, इट विल टेल यू व्हाट इट इज. सो व्हेन यू आर न्यू, यू मे नॉट रिमेंबर एवरीथिंग. सो जस्ट कीप योर कर्सर देयर. इट सेज ऐड सेक्शन. सो आई विल क्लिक ऐड सेक्शन. नो, अभी देखिए एक नया सेक्शन चालू हो गया. सो नाउ आई विल गो बैक हियर एंड से इफ इट इज यस, आई विल से गो टू सेक्शन टू. देखिए अभी गो टू सेक्शन टू ऑप्शन हैज कम बिकॉज आई एडेड अ न्यू सेक्शन. अर्लियर आई वी डिड नॉट सी दिस. सो आई विल क्लिक गो टू सेक्शन टू. ओके, व्हाट इज इन द सेक्शन टू? नाउ आई वांट टू गिव मोर ऑप्शंस. दैट मींस दे आर विलिंग टू अटेंड द ट्रेनिंग. सो आई वांट टू कैप्चर मोर ऑप्शंस. सो दिस इज अ टाइटल. आई विल जस्ट पुट सेक्शन टू फॉर नाउ जस्ट टू कीप इट क्विक इन द इंटरेस्ट ऑफ टाइम. And I'll add a question. The plus is adding a question. So what is a question? Training topics interested in. Okay. What are the options? I will say Trello, Google Form, proposal writing, communication skills. Okay, I'll just keep it 4 for now, just to, in interest of time. You can say add other. Maybe they want to suggest. Agar maan lijiye aapko poochna hai, you want to take a feedback from the people. I have given 4 options, but I want to say add other. So add other mein kya hota hai na? I want to write one more topic as a participant. I want to say presentation skills. Presentation skills either hai nahi. But if I click other and write presentation skills, it'll help me to analyze. Acha, how many people are asking for more topics beyond these 4, right? Then I can analyze that and introduce new topics, right? So I'll go with these 4. Now here, you understand one more difference. There are 2 things, multiple choice and checkbox. The difference is multiple choice, matlab, you can only select any one of the option, right? Agar maan lijiye aapne Trello select kiya, if I select Google Form, Trello selection chala jayega. I mean, from a response point of view, not now, whoever is responding. Multiple choice ka matlab hai, you can only select any one. Checkbox ka matlab hai, I can select more than one. Means I want to attend a Trello also, Google Form also, proposal writing also, everything. So I am giving the option to select more than one. So that is the difference between multiple choice and checkbox. So please understand this. ये थोड़ा समझ लीजिए, मल्टीपल चॉइस इज द ऑप्शन, अगर आपको एक ही चॉइस सेलेक्ट करना पड़ेगा, यू नो, चेक बॉक्स इज यू कैन सेलेक्ट मोर देन वन, मतलब एक से ज्यादा ऑप्शन आप सेलेक्ट कर सकते हो, राइट, दैट इज द चेक बॉक्स. सो इन दिस केस आई वॉन्ट चेक बॉक्स ऑप्शन, नॉट मल्टीपल चॉइस, बिकॉज आई एम गिविंग द ऑप्शन. अगर आपको ट्रेलो भी अटेंड करना है, गूगल फॉर्म भी अटेंड करना है, मोर देन वन ट्रेनिंग प्रोग्राम इफ यू आर इंटरेस्टेड टू अटेंड, यू आर मोर देन वेलकम, राइट. सो आई हैव टू सेलेक्ट चेक बॉक्स, सो दैट यू हैव टू रिमेंबर. अगर मान लीजिए मैंने मल्टीपल चॉइस कर दिया, देन पीपल कैन सेलेक्ट ओनली वन, सो देन दैट इज नॉट करेक्ट, राइट. आई एम गिविंग देम ऑप्शन, सो यू कैन चेंज एनी टाइम, यू नो, आप मतलब देख लीजिए, इफ आई चेंज इट इट बिकम्स राउंड, इफ आई मेक चेक बॉक्स इट बिकम्स स्क्वायर, सो दैट इज हाउ यू विल नो, एंड इधर भी दिखेगा आपको चेक बॉक्स. नाउ दिस इज ऑल्सो मैंडेटरी, आई वॉन्ट दैट रेस्पॉन्स ऑल्सो. नेक्स्ट वन मोर क्वेश्चन. नाउ हियर I'll show you another option, way of drawing option. Time preference. Okay. Day and time. I want to ask Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, which day of the week you are interested to attend, and morning session or afternoon session. Man lije, you want to ask a situation like this. So I want day and time preference. Here, there is an option known as multiple choice grid. You see this grid, इधर दो choices है, grid का दो है. This is similar to multiple choice, means in that each grid, one each row I can only select one option. Checkbox मतलब I can select more than one. So I will select more than one. I can, मान लीजिए I am giving morning, afternoon option and Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. Okay, I'll keep checkbox grid. So what should come in the rows? I'll say Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. Okay, I am not considering Sunday. Or columns mein kya hai? Morning session or afternoon session. I am giving these options. Okay, we'll see how it looks from a response point of view. So how it will look is all the Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday like this. And these two columns will appear at the top, morning, afternoon. So you will see a grid like that. Okay, they can select. This is also mandatory. So I am, what am I asking section two? What are the topics you're interested and what are the day and time preference? Okay, I'll keep it short. I will stop with this in the interest of time. So once I have completed the form, as I said, kuch save karne ka kuch zarurat nahi hai. Apne aap save ho gaya. Now I want to send this. Before sending, just ensure if you go to responses, accepting responses, jo hai na, this should be blue. If I tick this, red ho gaya, it says not accepting responses. You would do this when you're closing your survey. Okay. Agar maan lijiye ye selection mein aapne mail bhej diya, then they cannot submit the form. You cannot receive responses. So ensure that it is accepting responses. So, वो तो डिफॉल्ट में रहेगा ही, कुछ करने की जरूरत नहीं, जस्ट इन केस एक बार चेक कर लीजिए. इज दिस एक्सेप्टिंग रेस्पॉन्सेस. नाउ व्हाट वील डू इज वील सेंड दिस. सो वील सेंड दिस टू फ्यू पीपल. आई हैव फ्यू ईमेल आईडीज. आई विल जस्ट पिक अप. आई विल से अदिति एट connect4.org, Didi at connect4.org, and in comments, right? So I'm adding their email IDs and I can write. Any message you want. I'm just keeping it short this way. Here there is an option. Okay, subject B you can change. Chahiye to. Here there is an option called include form in email. By default it is not ticked. Iska matlab ye hai ki If I don't tick this, you get a mail with a link to the form. So aap link click karoge, then it will open a form in a new window. If I click this include form in email, this entire form will be visible in the mail itself. You don't need to open one more screen. Aur ek window open karne ka zarurat nahi hai. So in some cases you would prefer this, or in some cases you don't do this. So right now I'll not tick this. I'll remove this, but you can do both the things. So with this, I will say send. Okay. Now I request those four people to submit responses. Ab sab log dhyan dijiye, the responses abhi zero hai na? You don't see anything. As they update the responses, you can see the numbers here. So I request Aditi, Vidhi, Aarti, and Samina to quickly fill it up. Just with dummy responses. I'm sure we'll give them 2 minutes as they fill responses. Then we'll see how to extract the report. So as they are doing that, let it happen. Manliji, even if I close this now, let me say I close this form. Maine band kar diya usko. So in my main screen, you see I have it here. Connect for trial form. Right? When I came to my Google Drive, I see all my files. Here there is connect for trial form. So I just double click this. It will open it again. So I can close it, open it any number of times. Okay, it doesn't matter. And whatever I created, it's all here. See here, this is how it looks. Maine aapko bataya na, the grid, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, morning and afternoon session. So they can tick whatever they want. Can you see all of you? We got 2 responses already, right? It's instant. So I just submitted. They all received email as we are talking. Not even 1-2 minutes. 2 minute bhi nahi hua. The sooner they complete, you can see the responses here. If you click on the responses, you see the names of the people, right? Aarti and Samina have completed. You can see this is summary. These are the questions, and you can see one by one response in detail. Okay, so we'll see how to extract the report. So 2 people have submitted. Do we wait for the third, fourth? Are they doing? Samina, any idea?
I think Ravi, you can go ahead with the extraction of the responses.
Okay. No problem. Okay, fine. So as you can see, Aarti and Samina have given their responses. They have submitted, and we got it instantly. So there is no business of sending email. Then they download the form, wapas form fill karo, attach karo. None of that things, right? It has come instantly. Now I want to extract this report. How do I do that? If you can see this Excel icon, a create spreadsheet option. Just click that. Okay, it says create a new spreadsheet. Let it be, and just say create. So the moment you do that, it will open up a new spreadsheet, like a Google sheet, and you can see all the answers that you got. The first column is the date and timestamp when the response was submitted. That may not be relevant. So it is exactly telling you at 17:24, that is 5:24 and 21 second. So Aarti submitted then and Samita submitted at this time. And in the order of your fields, these are all your responses. Now, agar aap isko Excel mein dalna hai, very simple, just copy this, select this, select all these cells. I'm doing Control C. You can see the dotted line. मैंने कॉपी कर दिया. आई ओपन अ ब्लैंक एक्सेल. राइट, आई जस्ट पेस्ट इट हियर. दैट्स इट. ओके, यू कैन फॉर्मेट इट, ऑल ऑफ दैट. आई एम नॉट गेटिंग इनटू दैट, बट इमीडिएटली यू हैव ऑल द रेस्पॉन्सेस हियर इन एक्सेल. मान लीजिए 50 response, 100 response, 50 or 100 responses, any number of responses with one click of a button in that Excel spreadsheet here. And we got a third response as we speak. See, it got immediately updated. Vidhi responded and I got it right away, right? So that's the benefit of this. That's the power of this without you doing anything. So now if I know, now Vidhi also has given response, I can just copy Vidhi's responses. Copy, go here, paste. So I have all the responses. So you create an Excel file, save it separately. You can keep on checking. So I know till now three people have responded and I close the file. And manage it tomorrow morning, I open the file again, Google form, I see 10 responses. So then from fourth onwards, I can copy and paste. Or you delete this, you take a fresh download, you know, whichever way. Just aapko theek lage, you can do that. So as you can see, very easily you could compile the data. From now on, how you analyze, I'm sure all of you are good at Excel, so how to compile and analyze, you can do that, right? How many have asked for Monday morning, Tuesday morning, afternoon, see, all of that is here. So accordingly, you can plan your webinar sessions, training sessions, you know, all of that. I have all their email IDs, their names, what training topics they have asked for, sab kuch. Okay. So this is how you do it. Again, if you close this, it just goes, you see the three responses. This form stays here. As I said, kuch save karne ka zarurat nahi. Let's I just close this. I'll close this also. I've gone back to my mail. And tomorrow morning, I opened my mail. So again, I go to this Google Apps, the nine dots. Click that. Click Google Drive. It opens up the Google Drive page. Here, connect for trial form. I double click this. It opens up the, you know, this Google form. And you see the three responses. Imagine instead of three, it would have been four, five, 10, whatever it is. So you go to responses. You click this, your responses in sheet. It opens up the sheet again. All the data is saved here. So you can copy anytime. Kabhi bhi aap idhar se copy karke naya Excel file mein dal sakte ho. No, there is no limitation. You can keep on doing. Or you want to share this file with your team members, you can just click share, put their email ID. Ye pura ka pura sheet chala jayega. You know, suppose we are three people working in one project. I created the form, so isliye I am seeing it. I want to share this output file to them for them to analyze. So I just share, type their email ID. If I share like this, see, I get an, I can add them, give them the access. They can also see the sheet. And this is a Google sheet. And ek bar aapne responses sab accept kar liya. Let us say you gave a deadline. Till 31st July, please complete the survey. Okay. So on 1st August, when you log in, if I just tick this, not accepting responses. Matlab, teen responses ke baad, now if I click, now a fourth person cannot submit the form because I have closed it. I've closed my survey because I need to plan my training. And I thought, ek ek karke aata hi rahega, it gets difficult for me to analyze, right? I have to somewhere close it. So if you want to close, just close. Agar aapko lagta hai, chalo, aur ek hafta extend karenge, wapas open kar dijiye. Link will remain the same, okay? So this is the key point. Now, lastly, I know we are already towards the end of the time. The last point is how to send the link, this Google form link. See, because it was three people, what did I do? I went to send, maine idhar send click karke, wo teen email ID idhar type kar diya. But maan lijiye, I have to send it to 50 people. You know, it's difficult to type all the 50 IDs here. So what you do is, you go back to this Google Drive. Here I can see this connect for trial form, this file name, right click on this. When you right click, you see a lot of options. You don't bother about all of that. There is an option which says get shareable link. You see the option, get shareable link. You click this get shareable link. It will open up a window. This is the link to this particular Google form, right? This is a full link. Just say copy link. Okay, the link copied. It says link copied. Now I go back to my mail. I'll compose a new mail. Here I can just paste it. That's a link for you. And I can write, kindly fill this survey. And here I can copy, if I have 50 email IDs in one Excel file, I can copy paste in one shot, right? Of course, in Gmail, at one time, you cannot send more than 50 people. So to be safe, mark it only to 45 people, even in BCC also. So if you want to send it to 100 people, you have to send it in 2-3 batches. But in one shot, I can send this. So now this is the link. Now same link, I can send it through WhatsApp also. Okay, same link I copy, put it, transfer it to my mobile, put it on WhatsApp. You send it on WhatsApp, they click it on mobile, it'll open up the Google form exactly the way you see on computer. Okay, okay, mobile screen chota rahega, that's a different point, but you can open. So you can send it through WhatsApp also, the link, you can email it like this. So these are some of the key things. I've just touched upon some basic points and important points. We can go into detail, and there are other things maybe at a later point in time. So with that, I'll conclude my session and open for any questions.
Thank you, Ravi. We now request our audiences to allow the questions pertaining to the discussion that we had. So we can see few questions that are asked. So Samina,
question I see. Harish Bhatt. Ravi here. One question I see from Mr. Harish, but it says, is it necessary to copy and paste the data on Excel? Can we work on Drive itself? Of course, you can work on Drive itself directly, no problem. The reason I said in Excel is, see, the Drive is a Google Sheet. Google Sheet has certain limitations in terms of certain formula, formatting, etc., than a regular Excel. That is why I personally prefer to copy it in Excel. It's easy, right? That's all. Otherwise, you can do it there also. No problem.
Okay, so
Vishaka has asked, I would like to know if the data is already collected through Google Form. Can it be integrated to certify, to create certificates or auto certifications? You know, how can you issue auto certifications? Can that be done?
So when you say auto certification, are you referring like any training that you are doing?
Yeah, so say if you want to create a participation certificate or something like that, I think that is what Vishaka is asking, correct, Vishaka?
Okay. No, that is an offline thing. See, Google Form, the purpose is to collect responses on any topic, right, with certain options that you have given, like the quiz option I gave, you can do that. Now, certificate generation is a separate thing. Of course, there are learning management system tools, what is known as LMS tools, that is different. So there you have an integrated learning assessment with certificate, auto generation, all of that. So this is not an LMS tool. LMS stands for learning management system. So this is a pure only Google or just a form, right? So with the Google Form, you want to do certificate, that's a separate manual activity that you want to do that. But you can add on some apps to that. If you purchase a Google Suite with a paid subscription, you get some add-on apps to interlinkage, integrate with the Google Form. But in the free version, you cannot do that. You have to do manually offline. Yeah, Vishaka is saying there's a Certify EM which is free. Maybe then that gets integrated. Okay, I have not personally tried that. So if that works, great. Thanks, Vishaka, for that.
Kai, there's some question for you. In Trello, we need to create individual board for different projects, or can we add multiple projects in a single board?
Yeah, I can see that question. Yeah, you can create multiple projects in a single board. That's up to us on how we use the list. So the list which we saw, that list can be, okay, I'll share my screen for a minute now. So that list, guys, can be of anything. Like I use it being a consultant, okay, I use it for managing multiple projects. So now this is a project. Okay. So I can, for entire client, I'm using this one board. You can use it wherever you want. So this list will be one project, or either the board can be one project. Either of them is fine.
There's one more question which says, what are analytical stats provided by Trello?
None. Trello does not provide any analytical skills.
Okay. Ravi, there's a question for you. Mr. Gangadhar wants to understand more about drop-down list for countries. So do we have an option of countries over there?
Countries as in the names of countries?
Yeah, I want to know more about drop-down list, a option for countries.
No, to my knowledge, there is no standard country list in this free version. You create drop-down, you have to provide them one by one. Unless okay. In Excel, if you do, that's different. You can create lists and link up with the lists. But in Google Form, you have to provide the options individually.
Correct. Then Mr. Harish Bhatt is asking, maybe out of context, how can we use Mail Merge on Drive or Gmail? So Harish,
mail. Yeah. Mail Merge is to send bulk emails. Suppose I have a table with the names of people, first names and their email IDs. If I want to paste the mail, I want to say, dear Ravi, dear Kaid, dear Samina, dear Aparna, I can do that instead of saying dear all, right? Generally, if you put it in BCC, you'll write dear all. So Mail Merge gives you that flexibility. Again, that's an add-on app you need to buy, and then you can integrate with the Gmail. So that's an integration with Gmail with an add-on app that you can buy.
Maybe one more way of looking at that Mail Merge is, Ravi, can we use that link of form in the Mail Merge where we can send that link to multiple people?
Yes, we can. If you have the matter, Mail Merge, you will create a, what should I say, a body of the email standard. You will say, kindly find it as the survey link, please fill it by so-and-so, blah, blah, all of that. In the Mail Merge, you will create some variable fields. Dear, you will put, hash first name. So it will pick up the first name from the table, whatever is the first name. And you will say best regards, all of that. Let us say, if I give one more example of Mail Merge, in my accounts team, you want to send it with a payment due date to the employees, right? Or amount due that employees have to pay to the organization. So Ravi's due amount is 2,000 rupees, Kaid's is 1,000 rupees. So I can personalize, dear Ravi, your outstanding amount is, again, hash outstanding amount, whatever field name. So then what happens? Ravi's name is pasted with the due amount corresponding to Ravi. That is the flexibility you get in Mail Merge. I'm not typing 50 emails. In one email, I'm sending to 50 people, but with the customized information. That's the benefit of Mail Merge.
Thank you so much. One last question, Ravi. In Google Form, is there an option of responder to attach his or her file and send?
Attach their some attachment, you mean, or their responses?
This they just said that is there. Do can we attach any file while
responding? No. Once the submit, it automatically goes. There is because they're responding based on the options of the questions you have given as a creator. So there is no option. Once you click submit, it's gone. Separately, if they have to email with any attachments as a supporting documents, they can do that.
But in Google Forms, is not possible, right?
No. In Google Form, you cannot. And they are only responding to the options that you give.
Okay.
Scan copy of Aadhaar card or a PAN card as a scan copy as a response. Will I be able to do that?
Not to my knowledge. You will not be able to do that. You can scanned image that they have sent separately.
Okay.
So are there any other questions? So, I mean, yeah, we can't see any now.
Thank you so much, everyone, for joining.
Yeah. So we'll now wrap up the session. Thank you, Mr. Kair and Mr. Ravi, for breaking down the entire process of using these digital tools into a comprehensive and concise manner for us. I know that you both have extremely busy schedules with several webinars to speak at. So we are extremely thankful to you for being here and certain that every one of us, mostly the all the participants that were here, will be able to make use of this session and utilize all the information that they have received to their best abilities. Thank you everyone for joining us for the session today and being a wonderful audience. I request you to please fill the feedback form as it will help us curate more sessions like these. As mentioned earlier, if you have any questions that have remained unanswered in the session, please put it in the queries on the feedback form and we will be able to answer the questions offline. I hope to see you all in our next webinar, which is on cybersecurity on 5th of August 2020. We'll be sharing the details of the same on email and the WhatsApp group. Thank you once again for the great work that you all do. And have a nice evening.